All right. Well, hey, today we're going to talk about portfolios. So we've already, I'm going to share my screen here. We've already started talking about social media. Hopefully you've thought about that. And this idea of branding, right? This idea that, yes, we are consumers of media literacy, but we are also producers, whether we like it or not. And some of us have been producing stuff on social media thoughtfully, actively. That is called the push method. Right? Where we're pushing ourselves out there. We're pushing our information out there. There's also the pull method, right? And that's that idea of, hey, come watch our, look at my product. Come see my website. Come read my article. Come tune into my YouTube channel, whatever. And so, yes, we push ourselves out there in social media and our brand, establish our brand, but we still need a website. Right? And so maybe we get them hooked because they notice us on social media, but then we need to send them somewhere. Right? So, you know, imagine you're out, applying, or you're at a college fair, or maybe, you know, you go and meet with the scholarship application committee, or maybe you run into that college coach or a professor at media day, right? Or something like that. Wouldn't it be nice? You could give them, you know, maybe an address, a website where they can see more about you, more about your work. So that's kind of the idea. So we're going to talk today about websites. My challenge is we're going to make a portfolio. And so I want you to be mindful of it. Be thoughtful about, okay, what could we do with this and what might this look like? So our challenge today is we are going to make an online portfolio. And it's something that we're going to kind of work on and develop it over the course of this term, right? So here we go. First of all, I'm going to sell you on the benefits of a website. Now, I get it. The website benefits. Today, we're going to look at WordPress. Okay. Now, I know some of you are like, well, I've already got a website, or maybe could I use a different process? Why WordPress? Some of you are like Wix. Yes, there are great tons of versions out there and tons of user-friendly sites available. We're going to use WordPress today for a couple of reasons. There's tons of YouTube content out there and online support because WordPress is such a kind of a universally used or industry standard. There's so many resources out there for it. You don't have to be a coder or some like backwards internet language to be able to make one. It can be super simple. And also you can get a free account. You can get like, you know, your name, johnsmith.wordpress.com. And that, even just the .wordpress.com, has kind of become industry standard. It's become acceptable, especially if you're you pass out your portfolio and it's like your name.wordpress.com. That's kind of like people get that. Yes, there's tons of options. So that's why we're going to use WordPress. WordPress skills, having web skills, are totally resume builders. So having WordPress on your resume is a huge plus, right? Just think of, there's so many publications out there that use WordPress. Chicago Sun Times is a WordPress, New York Times, Beyonce. There it is. Beyonce's website is a WordPress. It's good enough for Beyonce. Mm-hmm. Disney, their website's WordPress. And here's the kicker, WLHSnow.com, the student media website, is a WordPress site. So we're going to kind of feed two birds with one scone here, right? We're going to learn how to build our own portfolio WordPress. And in so doing, we're going to kind of develop some of those resume skills and be able to say, hey, I know WordPress. Odds are you could maybe help get a job somewhere with somebody updating their WordPress site. And so that'll be a helpful tool. Also, you'll be able to be more familiar working with our student media site. And also the third reason that WordPress, this is going to be helpful. And if we do it right, it doesn't always have to be a site for just this high school, for this class, right? It can follow you. This site can follow you in a good way, hopefully. So don't use like Glenn's journalism class portfolio.wordpress.com. Because the idea is that you might be able to, you're starting a brand, you can establish a brand. We can change it. We can make it kind of work for you. So, you know, I've had students use it to get a job on campus in college. Right. My student, was a yearbook designer and she got a job at University of Oregon on Duck TV using her portfolio. You know, another student got a job at a magazine, as a freshman at University of Oregon, using her portfolio. So these sites can follow you. Maybe you have a side hustle. Maybe you want to start a photo business. Some of you could even be using it now. You know, you could have a tab on your WordPress site where you show off your portraiture that you take, your photography, and, you know, maybe start a little side business doing portraits, senior photos, right? Maybe you've got like an Etsy store that you could promote, right? Show off your wares, whatever that is. Blogs, maybe you want to turn this into a blog. Maybe you want to kind of use this WordPress. You know, oftentimes that's how freelancers get into the industry, is they start you start with a blog and then those blogs turn into books. You know, we've got freelance writers, authors, all have websites. So that's something to think about as you're going. I've got, you know, my buddy Tim from California, he's got his that he uses as a portfolio as a freelance artist, and he's kind of updated it over time. And so like he's an animator, an illustrator. And so he's got loads all of his portfolio here just so he can kind of show off his work. And I only know this because recently he got a job at DreamWorks. And so that's kind of cool. You know, you can see the stuff that he's done mostly like background animations, worked for Nickelodeon and that kind of stuff, and Walt Disney for a long time. But now he's at DreamWorks. So you can see that this could potentially follow you. Look, there he has, timallendesigns.com. You can totally do that. And Paige is a former student who took her WordPress, right? RodriguezPaige.wordpress. And yes, she has journalism skills on here that you can see, but she also added some of her creative writing. Right? She wanted a place to put her creative writing. And then she's got her photography over here. So, you know, if you click on this, you can see some of the photography that she's taken. So this gives you kind of an idea of what you can do with it, right? So that's what we are going to do today. And so let me talk about the format that we're going to use. We are going to use the Journalism Education of Association curriculum, kind of as the framework for how we're going to build our journalism portfolio that we're going to use for this class. And if we're smart about using it, this could be something that you could continue to use beyond high school, beyond this class. But this is going to be the framework for where we're going to be thinking about how we're going to present what we're learning in intro to media publications. And so there are 11 kind of media standards that they use. And as we go through this course, these are the terms or the skills that we're going to develop. We've already started talking about news literacy and what is news and how we are consumers and how we can be smart consumers and producers. And we are also going to continue. We're going to talk about news gathering, about how we interview, how we interact, how do we get information. Writing, we're going to work on that. Photojournalism, we're going to take photos in here. We're going to talk about law and ethics and what does it mean to be an ethical reporter and media producer. We're going to do some design, potentially some editing, working on the web, multimedia broadcast. Ultimately, more advanced students as you continue in media publications will work on entrepreneurship, maybe leadership and team building. But those are kind of the overview skills. And what we're going to do is we're going to create skill pages. And so what I've got for you is a handout that kind of overviews what our portfolio is going to look like. So I want to take a look at it here with you. And there is a link to this, so you can go and look this up in Google Classroom. But this WHS Now portfolio is the final portfolio that we're going to work on this term. And if you continue in these CTE classes, you'll add to this portfolio. So that's the idea. We're kind of setting the groundwork. So the idea is that this is going to kind of curate all of your work samples, showcase your skills. So it should reflect how much you've learned, feature examples that evidence your growth. So here are the things that your portfolio should include. It should include a statement of purpose, like an introduction, kind of like when you go to your site, what's the first thing people see? We're going to write kind of like a welcome to my site. There's going to be an about page where you write a little biography. We've already kind of worked on that, talking about what that might look like. And then we're going to create some work samples over the course of the semester. And as we go and as we learn, we're going to start adding things to this portfolio. So I wanted to kind of set the groundwork now. Level one students in this intro class, you're gonna need just 5 of these skills. So we're going to probably touch on 7 or 8 of them, but you're going to pick the 5 that you're most proud of or you're proudest of to include in your portfolio. So, you know, these are kind of the introductory skills that we'll likely cover. And then maybe you'll add one of these intermediate skills as well. You absolutely can add to them. And when we do these work samples, we're going to do like a photography activity and you're going to take some photos. And what you're going to do in your portfolio on your photo skill page, you're going to add those, put that evidence, the photos that you've taken, and then you're going to write a little reflection examining how this work sample represents your growth. Right? So what did you learn about photography from this project? Right? And so you're going to write a little reflection for each entry. So that's going to be kind of the idea of how we're going to do the work samples. So you'll have a page with maybe a design, something that you've designed, and then you'll write a little reflection. Here's what I learned in this design project. Or maybe we'll do a video and under multimedia broadcast, and you'll, here's a video that I made, and here's what I learned about multimedia broadcast, right? And so we'll do that as we go. So kind of to give you an overview, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a free account on WordPress. And you're going to build these pages. And again, you're going to want to be able to come back and reference this. This kind of gives you a step-by-step, here's what each of your page needs. First thing we're going to do, we're going to build a home page. On that home page, you're going to write kind of a welcome. And here are the things that you could do. Here are the things. What does the portfolio mean to you? What does this portfolio reflect? How does it reflect your growth as a journalist? So on that home page, you'll kind of write about, welcome to my website. Here's what I've learned about journalism. This shows how I began interested in this and then how I developed an interest in this. Maybe describe your intentions. Maybe explain what the viewer will find, like a teaser or a table of contents. So on the statement of purpose, you'll maybe say, make sure you check out this skill page where I'm proud of this, and just kind of tease if they only click on one or two of the pages, which ones do you want to make sure that they click on? So that'll be a home page. Then you're going to create an about the author page. We probably talked about this already, but you're going to have a brief writer biography, kind of think like a Twitter or an Instagram bio. Include the 3 P's, something personal, something professional, something purposeful. We've been talking about that. So think about, make sure that they know you're a human, right? Make sure there's something that talks about the profession of media, of journalism, photography. What is it? What aspect of it? Maybe it's a content area. Maybe you're really interested in politics. What aspect of journalism interests you? And then purposeful. Where do you see yourself in the future? Bonus, some students, as they continue on, the about the author page is a great place to put like a journalist resume. You're going to have opportunities to compete at regional journalism competitions, media competitions. So there's also a place for that. Then you're going to have work sample pages. So you'll have a page that says photojournalism, right? And a page for each journalism skill that you've obtained. You'll have another page for news gathering, right? And another page for a web page for, what are the other ones? Law and ethics. And so as we go through each of those units, you'll create a new page and you'll add work samples. So under each skill, you'll include a work sample or evidence that shows you've obtained that skill. For those who continue and take more journalism classes, it'll be fun to see that you add to that skill. It'll be fun to see maybe the photos you took as a freshman or as you in your first, after in your intro course. And then maybe after you've taken a couple more courses to see how your photography's developed. So lots of my students just keep those entries on their photojournalism page and then add continue to add more and more, or maybe add them to the top and push them down. So that's something that you can do. And before each work sample, just give a brief reflection, introducing the work sample, give the reader context for the story or for the project. How does this show your skill, right? And then we'll have a contact page, right? So if you hand this website to a scholarship committee or a coach or a potential job applicant, you want to have some sort of contact page. And WordPress is really great because it has a template where there's an automatic form in there. And so people, if you add that contact form, people can type it in and it's secure, and WordPress will send you an email alerting you that somebody's trying to get a hold of you. Do not include personal information on that contact page. Don't put your phone number on there. Don't put your email. Don't write that out, because then you'll get bots spamming you, and that's just not safe, not wise. So the nice thing about WordPress is it filters out all of that spam. And so whatever account you set up your WordPress account with, that's the email that WordPress will filter and contact you and let you know that you have a message. So that's the idea. That's kind of the basics of what your portfolio is going to look like. And if you continue to scroll down here, you'll see the scoring rubric by the end of the term. Again, this is a bulk of, you know, you've got your staff assignments and your portfolio. And this makes up the remainder of the grade. And this is what it's going to look like, right? Formulates interesting, engaging introduction. That homepage, does it grab our attention? Right? Does it demonstrate your purpose and the ideas, right? If it says, welcome to my site under construction, right? That might be a little bit more limited, right? A little progressing, but it should be thoughtful, right? Do you have an author bio that communicates personality, professionalism, sense of purpose, right? Do you hit on all of those things, right? That's what we're looking for. So that's gonna be worth 10 points. Does it have a contact page without any personal information on it, like an email or phone number? You don't want to include those, right? So put that in there. Is it easy to navigate through the page? Can I find all of your work samples, right? And we'll talk about how to set that up in a clear way. Do you have work sample pages with a number of skills based on your level? So if you're in this intro class, do you have 5 different work samples with evidence? Do you have work samples that are meaningful, right? That show your student growth? Hopefully those are meaningful examples that relate to those skills and tell that. Do you have reflections for them, right? There's another 10 points. Do those reflections explain the learning, show how you've developed that skill, right? And then, you know, does this show that you worked at it? Was there effort in, or are there all kinds of just the stock photos? Did you do the minimum? Hopefully you're going in and you're adding personal touches to your site. Is it complete? Does it have all of the required elements? And is it visually appealing, right? Does it look like it's completed, or does it have like random stock photos of coffee cups that are unrelated to your topic? So that's the basic overview of the portfolio that we're going to work towards by the end of this term. So hopefully you can be thinking about that and thinking about, as you're doing your projects, each of these, be thinking about how can I put this or include this in my portfolio. And now on this last page, I've got a setup. In the next video, I'll walk you through exactly how to set up this WordPress, and we'll go kind of step by step. Here are instructions right here, but I'll walk you through it. And if you go all to the last one, there's some useful links here. These are some more information about the introductory skills. The nice thing about using these 11 kind of content area skills is there's a scholarship program, the Journalist of the Year portfolio scholarship. And so the requirements of the scholarship are that you submit a portfolio with these 11 standards. And so if you continue on and build this up and add to this portfolio, you could potentially present this portfolio to that scholarship. So that's a cool thing that we'll be developing. But also, because of that, there's a ton of awesome student example websites with all of these 11 criteria out there. And so there's also a rubric that the scholarship committee has published. So you can see exactly what does it look like to have a really good news gathering skill page, or to have a really good writing or photojournalism skill page. So you can click on that link and it'll show you. And I've just kind of pulled some of the descriptions on here just to remind you. Again, as we go through the class and take these different units, you'll be able to, we'll learn more about each of these skills as we go. There's also a number of tutorials and videos that can help you go on using WordPress. Here is a link also where some of those award-winning Journalist of the Year WordPress portfolios are. And so you could look at some of those and maybe get some ideas if you're not sure what to put for news literacy. There's some ideas on what that looked like. And I pulled some links to some cool sites that you could check out that might be interesting. I mentioned a couple of these. I mentioned Pages Photography here, Tim's. This is another student of mine who quickly turned their WordPress portfolio with all their journalism entries and made it their own personal writing site. And so this is where Kaylee put, you know, novel excerpts and articles she's published, poetry, short stories, right? So, there's a lot of things that you could do with this. This is a student from several years ago who did this. This is her Westland High School journalism portfolio. And you can see all of her skills and standards here. And she actually was the Oregon State Journalist of the Year. And she won for the state of Oregon the scholarship and went to the national convention and represented Oregon for the National Journalist of the Year. And so this kind of shows all of the skills that she did. The cool thing about this one, this is Emily's site, is that she went on to University of Montana to study journalism there. And so she's focusing on climate change studies. And so, you know, if you go through here, she's got her about, but the cool thing is she continued her website. It's just Emily Rebecca Martin, right? It's her name. So she can make it whatever she wants. She kept this up, but then she also added the things that she's doing in at university. So here are some internships she's done, some videography, some photojournalism. She's a social media coordinator. So then, she added some work samples from things that she's doing in college. So those are some ideas, some things that you can do. Oh yeah, and Beyonce, right? I don't think I have a link to Beyonce on in here, but there's some other, national journalism winners and their portfolios that you can take a look at. And hopefully that'll be helpful. So that's what we've got for today. Check out the next video where we're gonna kind of get into the nuts and bolts of WordPress and actually start you from scratch creating it. So get those wheels turning, get thinking about how you might use your portfolio. All right.